She was amazing, said Nick. She taught me how to surf and I was terrified at first. But once I got up there, it felt absolutely fantastic and I caught some waves pretty well. Nick quickly learned how to do the 360 degree spins on his board. He quickly learned how to do 360 degree spins on his board. What do you mean by 360 degree spins? What do you mean by 360 degree spins? Means completely he was able to stand upside down on his head. When you do a 360 degree spin, you completely make yourself upside down. He quickly learned how to do the 360 degree spins on his surfing board. A feat means an achievement that got him on the cover of the Surfer magazine within 48 hours. Within 48 hours of joining to learn the surfing on surfing board, his photograph was fixed there in the Surfer magazine, printed on the Surfer magazine. No one has ever done that in the history of surfing, he said. Doing 360 degree spins on a surfing board, no one has ever done that in the history of surfing itself. But how he could do that, that's what he's explaining there. But I have a very low center of gravity, so I have got pretty good balance. Because of his low center of gravity, he was able to do the 360 degree spins without much difficulty. Because he would have a pretty good balance due to his low center of gravity. He has visited different countries all over the world. The football fan is now a motivational speaker and has traveled over 24 countries speaking to groups of up to 110,000 people. And Nick has visited different countries all over the world. That football fan, you know, at the beginning we have learned that Nick was a huge fan of English Premier League, the football annual football event of London. That football favorite or fan is now a motivational speaker. Means a person who can motivate, who can inspire others with his speeches. Now he became a motivational speaker and he has traveled over 24 countries and sometimes speaking to groups consisting of 110,000 people, 110,000 people. Really great. He moved to Los Angeles 2 years ago in 2007 and plans to continue to travel the world. Then from Melbourne, he moved to Los Angeles in 2007 and he plans to continue to travel the world to convey his message of hope for the others. If I fail, I try again and again and again. Who is speaking these words? Nick. See, my dear friends, if I fail, I try again and again and again. If you fail, are you going to try again? He's asking a question to us, we people. Nick is asking posing this question to everybody in this world. If I fail, I try again and again and again. If you fail, are you going to try again? The human spirit can handle much worse than we realize. My dear friends, don't underestimate your spirit, human spirit. Human spirit can handle much worse situations than I have been here in this. See, what can be worse than having no limbs at all? But did human spirit of Nick not make him stronger in his belief? That shows that human spirit can handle much worse situations. Much worse means much worse than what Nick had faced in his life. But much worse situations also our human spirit can handle. So that power of soul, spirit means soul, is so strong that it can handle the worst situations on the earth. Only thing that matters to you is how you are going to finish. How you are going to finish Are you going to finish strong or are you going to finish weak? It all depends on you and you only. Are you going to finish strong to overcome your disability, to overcome your problem and become successful in your life? You have to be strong in your beliefs. I tell people to keep on getting up when they fall and to always love themselves, he said. One more thing, my dear friends, I tell the people again and again is that to keep on getting up when they fall. What's the meaning of keeping on getting up? Keep on means continue. Keep on getting up when they fall. What does it mean? Every time we should fall down and get up? No, that's not the meaning there. Keep on trying when you fail. That's what I tell the people. And don't hate yourself because you have failed. He says that I tell people to keep on getting up when they fall and to always love themselves. Just don't get depressed. Don't start hating yourself because you have failed one or two times. We know every failure is a stepping stone to success. So, my dear friends, I tell you to keep on getting up whenever you fall. Means, I tell you, my dear friends, to go on trying and trying and trying till you are successful. If I can encourage just one person, then my job in this life is done. Maybe God had made me like this to give courage to others. That's what I realized after reading that article. If I can encourage one person, that article had encouraged me. That article had given me courage. In the same way, if I can encourage at least one person in my life, then my job in this life is done. Then I can feel that I have done justice to my life. Really modest. He had inspired thousands of people around the world as a motivational speaker. But he says modestly, if I can just influence one person, if I can encourage just one person, then I can feel that I have done justice to my life. And there is a conclusion given there in the box at the end of the lesson. See, this everybody should be very carefully following. Body structure and looks are inborn. See, my dear friends, the way you look, your appearance, your looks, your beauty or your handsomeness, your body structure are all inborn. We did not choose or make our body. Can we choose or can we make our own body when we were born? No. We cannot choose our body, we cannot make our body. We need not take pride or feel ashamed of our looks or body structure. So, my dear friends, this is the body created by the God. Through the parents. This is a body created by the God. So, we need not feel ashamed or we need not feel pride about our body structure or our looks. Pride or shame comes from our behavior. When should we feel proud or when should we feel ashamed of? We should not feel proud or we should not feel ashamed of our looks or body structure. Because pride or shame comes from our behavior, not from our looks. You are not respected because you are looking handsome or beautiful. You are respected because your behavior is good. We respect people. And people respect us for our skills, behavior and qualities. We respect other people and other people respect us. For what? For what purpose? They respect us? They respect our beauty? No. They respect us for our skills, for our qualities, for our behavior. So, my dear friends, don't feel pride or feel ashamed of your looks or body structure because they are not made by you. They are inborn qualities that cannot be changed by anybody. With this, we come to the end of the lesson. Let us go to comprehension now. There are some questions given there, 11 questions given at the end of the lesson. When we discuss these questions, that means we are going to revise the entire lesson once again. That's what we need to understand. Dear friends, we will be discussing these questions now. First question, I call it my chicken drumstick, joked Nick. What does it refer to? What does it refer to? It refers to the small foot that grew on his left hip. This is how we have to write. It refers to the small foot that grew on his left hip. How does it help him? Already we discussed this in the first page of the lesson. It helps him to balance. You can see there, it helps him to balance. It helps him to hold a pen or a pencil. It enables him to kick the things. It enables him to type or write with a pen and pick things up between his toes. This is how that chicken drumstick helps him. What do you mean by right girl or right boy to marry? Already we discussed this in the previous class. What do you mean by right girl or right boy to marry? Right means you are suitable. Suitable in all the aspects. A right boy or a right girl to be married means the person or the girl or boy should be able to understand our feelings. Should be always with us through thick and thin. Should always be encouraging us. Should not humiliate us because of our disability or inability. Such a kind of person who is helpful or understanding in nature in all aspects of the life is called a right girl or a right boy to marry. His parents, question number three, his parents decided not to send him to a special school. Was Nick happy about his parents' decision? Of course, he said at the beginning he was not happy. He said it was hard for him because he knew that he would be bullied, teased. It is given there in the lesson. He was not happy at the beginning, but he says it may have been the best decision they had made for him. They might have made for him. What do you think about this decision? Suppose you are asked a question. Was it correct on the part of the parents of Nick to send him to a normal school, not to a special school? Do you think it is a correct decision taken by the parents of Nick? It is your own answer you have to make. You have to support your answer. If yes, why? If not, why not? If yes, why? If no, why not? How did Nick's parents help him to become independent? So, this is in the second page of the lesson. Nick's parents helped him in different ways to make him independent. His father put him in the water tub to make him learn how to swim when he was just 18 months old. And his father also taught him how to type with his toe when he was just 6 years old. His mother invented a special plastic device so that he could hold a pen or a pencil. And they gave him an electric wheelchair for mobility. These are the different ways his parents helped him become independent. Pick out the symptoms of Nick's depression. What are called symptoms? Signals. Generally, when you are suffering from fever or about to suffer from fever, you feel some symptoms there, like giddiness or sometimes vomitings. These are called symptoms. Nick felt depressed and he tried to commit suicide when he was 8 years old. First time he told his mother that he wanted to kill himself. Then at the age of 10 years, he wanted to drown himself in a bathtub to kill himself. But that was also a failure. So these are the symptoms of Nick's depression. Do you think his depression was normal or something unique about him? Such kind of depression is a normal thing among the children like Nick? Or do you think it was only unique or special about only Nick? You have to give reasons also. So we cannot say that it was unique about Nick, because whoever is suffering from such kind of disability, they feel such a kind of depression. It's very normal, quite normal. It's not unique about Nick or anybody else. It is common to all. We feel depressed when we are unable to do some things on our own because of our disabilities. Sixth question, which incident in this text is funny? What makes it funny? The incident in which the girl at a traffic light looking at Nick interestingly when he was sitting in his car seat. And that what made it actually interesting is when he, because she could see only his head there in the car, he made a 360 degree spin to freak her out. Seeing him like that, that girl sped off really quickly from there. That particular thing makes it a funny incident. Question number 7. What made Nick choose Bethany Hamilton as his teacher to learn surfing? See, Bethany Hamilton was a girl, when she was 12 years old, her arm was bitten off by a shark. She had no arm at all. And Nick chose her as his surfing master because he thought only a physically disabled or challenged person only can understand the feelings of other physically disabled or challenged people. So he chose her as a surfing master. Question number 8. Which aspect of Nick's physical condition helps him to do a 360 degree spin? His low center of gravity. This is the aspect of Nick's body or physical condition that makes him, that helps him do the 360 degree spins easily. Okay, what is the physical condition of Nick that helps him to do the 360 degree spins without much difficulty? It was his low center of gravity. Okay, question number 9. What are the distinct features of this text? List them. Distinct means what? Special. What are the special features? What do you mean by features? Special qualities. What are the special qualities or features of this text? You have to write in the form of a list. It is motivational. Like this you have to write. You have to write a list like this. It is motivational and inspiring. It is a simple and straightforward narration. Like this, you have to write a list of the special features of this text. Question number 10. What do you learn from the life of Nick Wiewoszczyk? Have you learnt any lesson from the life of Nick Wiewoszczyk? Of course, everybody must have learnt something. What is that? We should keep on trying whenever we fail. That doesn't mean that we should keep on failing. We should not feel depressed or discouraged just because we have failed sometimes. We should keep on trying and trying and trying till we succeed. That's what we have to learn from the life of Nick Wiewoszczyk. Do you think disability is an obstacle to achieve success in life? Disability means any physical challenge. Physical disability like that Nick had suffered throughout his life. Is it an obstacle or is it a hindrance? An obstacle means a hindrance. Or we call it a stumbling block. Which stops our progress. What is called a hindrance? Something that stops our progress. Or something that stops from us stops us from proceeding further in the life. So, can you say that disability is an obstacle to achieve success in life? Never. A disability can never be an obstacle in the success of anybody's life. Nick's life itself tells us so. Substantiate means prove. Your argument citing evidence from Nick's Vujicic biographical account, attitude is altitude. From this lesson, we can easily understand that physical disability or any disability is not going to be an obstacle or hindrance or a stumbling block for anybody to achieve success in life. For example, Nick was born without limbs. He suffered throughout his life. He faced teasing and bullying from his friends. He tried to commit suicide. Then he had read an article about a disabled person which changed his attitude towards life. He started hating the God for having been given the birth like that. These are the evidences from the story, from Nick's biographical account, attitude to altitude, that disability cannot be an obstacle for one's success in life. Okay, children. Next, number two, in this, given below are some of the statements made by Nick Vujicic. Which of these are substantiated by Nick's life? Substantiate means proved. How are these substantiated by Nick's life? You can see some of the statements made by Nick himself. I realized why God had made us like this, to give hope to others. I wanted to concentrate on something good that I had. I tell people to keep on getting up when they fall and to always love themselves. If I can encourage just one person, then my job in this life is done. All these are statements made by Nick. Are all these statements substantiated by his life or not? Of course, all these are substantiated, are proved in his life, by his life. We can say it very clearly. All these statements made by Nick really substantiate his life. Now, vocabulary. You can see a list of adjectives given below in the box. Which of them describe Nick Vujicic? Tick them. The first question in this vocabulary part is, in every set there are three words given. Which of those adjectives, all these are adjectives, remember that. Which of these adjectives describe Nick's life? Tick those things. After that, what we have to do in the next page, you see, pick out from the text the examples that support these attributes. Attribute means qualities. Positive, cowardly, arrogant. Out of which word or which adjective describes Nick? Positive. You can see in the next page, in the first one is given as an example, that attribute or quality of Nick in the first three words is positive. What is the example from the text that supports this attribute? That is also given there. In spite of his disability, he has become great. Is this the example from the text which explains his positive attitude or not? So you have to tick that word and write that word that you have picked up there under attribute column. Then you have to write one sentence or one instance from the text, one example from the text. Not necessarily the direct sentences. One example or instance from the text which supports that particular quality. Second set of words, you can see negative, courageous, sarcastic. So you can tick courageous there. Write that word there under attribute again as a second number and write an example for that. Think of those examples. Optimistic, reliable, quarrelsome. The third set of words, optimistic, reliable, quarrelsome. Optimistic means having the hope to achieve something. Reliable means which can be depended upon. Quarrelsome. So you have to tick optimistic. Write that attribute there against the third number in the table in the next page and write one instance from the text. Then pessimistic, independent, rude. We have to tick independent there. In the same way, generous, dependent, creative. He is creative in nature. In what way you have to pick up an example from there? Nervous, next set. Nervous, obedient, stubborn. Which quality or which attribute describe Nick of these three words, three adjectives you have to pick up and write. Confident, trusting, lazy. Next set of words, smart, valiant, pompous. Last set of three words, sociable, self-centered, level-headed. How can you identify which word is the correct word or which adjective can best describe Nick's quality, Nick's life, sorry. Which best describe Nick? Which means you have to know the meanings of all these adjectives there. Then only you can pick up the correct quality and write that word there under the column attribute and then write one example for that. So, first what you have to do is write the meanings of all these words, find out the meanings of all these words, adjectives given there and tick the box there, write that attribute or quality there under attribute column and then write an example. Okay, children, this is the exercise that you must be doing. You must know the meanings of all the words. Second question in this is, tick the word or expression which is nearest in meaning to the word underlined in each sentence given below. So there are four options for each and every sentence there. You have to tick the correct one. Water sports aren't Nick's only thing. He also plays golf with a club tucked under his chin. What is tucked under his chin? Tied under his chin. There was a club tied under his chin with a rope or something with which he used to play golf. His distraught mother couldn't bring herself to hold him until he was 4 months old. Distraught means anxious, worried. You have to tick that word D. Despite the risk of bullying, his parents insisted on Nick's attending mainstream school. What's bullying? Humiliation. Answer is B. Nick, who was teased and bullied, had an electric wheelchair for mobility and a team of carers to help him. What is the meaning of mobility? Movement. B answer. Nick managed to pull through to become an international symbol of triumph over adversity. Adversity means what? Difficulties. C. The challenges in our lives are there to strengthen our convictions, beliefs. C answer. Like that, you have to tick the correct word, correct meaning of the underlined word given there in the sentences. In the question number 3, read the following descriptions about persons and fill in the blanks with the words that match with these descriptions. This will be taken up in the next class. Children, let us end this. And next class we'll meet and discuss these parts along with grammar and writing task. Okay, children? Thank you.